Hey, what up, guys? It is DiplexHeated again, and welcome to Scourge of War, Gettysburg, the 150th Anniversary Edition. Some of you might have played this game, some of you might have heard of it. It's kinda, I'm not gonna, you know, compare the games, but it reminds me, at least, of Take Command, Second Manassas. It has the same sort of graphics feel to it. Some people don't like it, some people love it, some people are okay with it. I kinda like it. I'm gonna be honest, the graphics does not make the game. If you think so, then you probably shouldn't be playing video games yet. Just in a few years, perhaps. At least, Lego games. Probably two. Anyway, that aside, we're going to be playing a Gettysburg campaign. As you can tell, this video is titled, 1st of July, 1 p.m. I believe that would make sense. Yes, I believe 1 p.m. is the first. No, actually, it isn't. Because a.m. and p.m. in my world doesn't make any sense. I've never gotten the hang of those. Pre-midday, after midday, I think. Or is it after midnight? It's probably after midnight. Anyway, so it's 9:50 after midnight. It's July the 1st. We're in Gettysburg. And this is the first scenario. Thank God because of these numbers. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to to work my way around it. But so yeah, this video will probably last us about 40 minutes. We're in command of Buford's 1st Cavalry Division. We've all seen the movie Gettysburg, I hope. And we're in McPherson's Ridge. We've all seen the scene where he rides up there and he's like, "Oh, the Confederates are coming," and they set up their guns and they dismount, and he's up in that clock tower, or that the town hall, just overlooking the battlefield. So we're going to be commanding Brigadier General Buford here and his division, with the following regiments, 2 brigades and a battery. Interesting stuff. There's just so many historical aspects to this game. So this is the one we're going to head into, and I'm excited. So if you've seen the movie and have, or watched the, yeah, seen it, know more about the Battle of Gettysburg than most, etc., etc., you'll probably be very familiar with these battles anyway. But yeah, this is very cool. This is nice. The keyboard controls. There's a lot of things going on. It's a lot of like secondary controls there on the keypad. It's interesting. Anyway, we're gonna jump straight in. So this is the kind of graphic style I'm talking about. Everyone familiar with it? Yeah? Who's that? Is that courier? Yes. 2nd Brigade, Devon, McPherson's Ridge, 9:45, July 1st. General Buford, my scouts have reported the movement of large bodies of enemy troops to the northeast. As planned, I am moving part of my command north of Gettysburg. The rest will follow. Our infantry is approaching from the south. Colonel Thomas Devon, officer commanding 2nd Brigade, 1st Division, Cavalry Corps, Army of the Potomac. Roger that, sir. Buford. Who's that? Colonel Thomas E. Devon, yes. Right, so here's Gettysburg. Got McPherson's Ridge up here. This is very familiar to me. Got our cavalry set up here. It's the 12th Illinois, 8th Illinois, 3rd Indiana, and 6th New York. And the Confederates are coming! As suspected. Get in cover, boys. Get in cover. Got a little bridgehead to cover up here. God damn it, we ain't got time to slack about. I think our artillery is opening up already. Well. That'll do you fine, that'll do you fine. Dismount the infantry. It's 9:51. in the morning. And these guys, we're gonna set them up right here in the is this corn? Cornfield. Courier message. General Buford, I am approaching the field with the lead brigade of Wadsworth's division. The rest of the corps follows. Major General John F. Reynolds. Interesting. So, Reynolds is the guy that comes in and saves the day, as you should know. I will advance on foot or on horse. Doesn't matter now. Cavalry boys are at the ready. 3rd Indiana. There's a lot of these guys here. Hold your position. Colonel William Gamble, he's in command of these guys, and these guys, and these guys. Actually, pretty much all of them, yeah. He is the commanding officer of the front right here. Oh, the 8th New York decided to arrive. Great. They're from the 1st Brigade. 1st Division, yeah, they're part of the same here. I'm gonna quickly rush them here to the side. Actually, I think I will... I'll keep them as a reserve for now. 8th New York has arrived, sir. Welcome to the field, boys. I'm gonna take a man from the AI, so I am now in charge. AI sometimes do minor adjustments to their movements. A little closer, boys, a little closer. Dismount. Confederates in the open. We're ready to engage, sir. Fire at will. Okay. There we go. They're going to march over. Brigadier General Joseph R. Davis. 2nd Mississippi. 55th North Carolina. Firefight, fellows. We're gonna advance from the flank. Provide some covering fire there from the side. 6th New York here on the side. That should be enough. Let him have it, boys. Right. 8th New York. Big section. We'll make a column. We'll use the road. We'll go there and we'll use the road. I'm gonna hold them off from the center. In column, boys. In column. Using the road always is faster. Forward! 2nd Lieutenant John H. Califf. The A Battery. Battery A 2nd U.S. Artillery. I don't know who they're aiming at. They're shooting at the targets back there. We have spare guns here. We're going to bring them in. More of the brigade is arriving slowly. There's more coming from back here. Who's this? Captain James A. Hall, Battery B, the main artillery. They're starting to arrive now. Where is the goddamn Iron Brigade? In line, boys, in line! Don't have Confederates. It's 42nd Mississippi, 14th Tennessee, 5th Alabama Battalion, 13th Alabama, 1st Tennessee. This one's way smaller. Oh, what a hit. Oh, we got him on the run there. Doesn't mean we're gonna stop. Need to continue forward. This is a big section, 435 men. The 8th New York Cavalry. I'm not following up super realistically here. I mean, technically, I think they would be along these lines the entire section. But yeah, this'll do. Not the most legitimate artillery position. Shooting at the 5th Alabama Battalion, 150. Nope, these guys aren't actually firing at anyone. No valid targets in weapon range. Should move the guns, move the guns. Roll them up, roll them up. I would like to dispatch like a courier message or something. I'm gonna go look at Buford. John Buford. What's this? Supply wagon? Yeah, ordnance supply wagon. Hurry now. Oh, there's John F. Reynolds. Has he arrived yet? Oh, here comes the Corps. Ah. Sweet boys, on the way. Well, now we wait. Now we wait. It's almost 10 o'clock. And the battle is raging on, literally. Being a bit aggressive here. Keep up the fire, boys. Keep up the fire. 12th Illinois, taking a lot of casualties. They're starting to pull back here, actually. Guns made it up. They're firing. Gotta make them. Ooh. That's a different type of gun. Target those bastards. This one's having difficulties getting targets going. Well, that's fine. Not everyone can. You'll be fine if you move there. Got a good fire there at the enemy. Gotta support 8th Illinois. God damn it, William. Get your ass out of there. Oh, shit. 12th Illinois broke. We're gonna have to fall back. Fall back, fall back. But I'm certain we can hold this flank without any major sacrifices. We just gotta face the Confederates in the white eye here. 55th North Carolina trying again, previously routed. I intend to beat them. Oh, How's it going, guys? 30 Indiana. Defensive terrain here. We're a bit of a trench. I think we're doing pretty well. 30 casualties. I think we're laying it down here pretty well here on the 42nd Mississippi. Keep up the fire, boys. Keep up the fire. Coming from the flanks. Yep. Damn, center is open. God damn it. Morale is still high, but they've fallen back. Or they've fallen back, should I say. God damn it. I don't know where they're heading. They're legging it out of here. Now they're on horseback, even. They've mounted up and they're heading back. Christ. Oh, we gotta fall back here as well. It's not looking that pretty, guys. Gotta be honest with you. We're not gonna be able to take a bayonet charge from these guys. But looks like we can push them back again. A little too close for comfort there. Keep up the fire, boys. Both guns are firing now. There we go. Oh, god damn it, General. Colonel. Too close. I really need John F. Reynolds and his infantry up here now. That is not a joke. We need to push them back into the other side. Oh, use canister. That's a certainty. Just use canister. Using canister, fire! Firing for effect! Oh, we pushed them back. Well, we gotta take the field. Advance, guys, advance! Forward, man! Forward! New York! It's actually the 3rd Indiana. I believe 8th New York were the ones who routed. I can't keep an eye on all of them. Oh, the fucking brigade is finally starting to gather up. 12th Illinois, though, got their shit together. They're gonna be well needed. 8th New York. Disappointing right now. There we go. They finally got their shit together as well. Oh, shit. Coming from the flanks, we got a wheel. Got lots of Confederates to face off here. It's not looking good. It's 5 minutes past now. Cavalry's starting to get the shit together again. The 8th New York and 12th Illinois coming back to play. Don't worry, they submerge themselves every now and then. That happens. The beauty of the realism here, or at least the battle itself, and the history, man, it's like historical orgasms I get. I just think of the movie, I think of the battle, I think of everything going on here. Keep moving! And we'll dismount there. We'll get a line going. We'll start opening fire. These guys are going to try and get on our flanks. Smart. But the 8th New York will prove themselves again. We need to push forward. I'm gonna get the cavalry around here to the cornfield. Let's try and push out the 13th Alabama. Alabama. Come on, boys. East New York, dismount, open fire, open fire. Advance down to the waterfront. East New York. This is badass. We need to hold McPherson's Ridge. Ordnance supply just probably just filled us up there and heading back. How's ammo looking? 102 shells. Solid 48 shell 12. Yeah, we got rounds. We got rounds. Oh, good hit. You shrapnel on these guys. I mean, that is deadly. They can feel the pressure now. I think I'm gonna put some more pressure here on the... on the 42nd Mississippi. They start... Oh... Probably gonna fall under the pressure.
Dismount and open fire! Come on! Push him in! Push him in! Forward, man!
Probably breaking a sweat now, huh? Yeah, they're pulling back. They're pulling back. Over here, things are looking pretty grim.
Keep up that fire, man. Keep up the fire.
We got advanced down in the open. Man up here. 13th Alabama. Knowing the hell out of me. It's 10 past 10 now soon. Where is the entire corps? Looks like they're getting set up to arrive here. This is Brigadier General Lysander Cutler. 2nd Brigade, 1st Division, 1st Corps. We were just chilling here. We got James S. Wadsworth, 1st Division, 1st Corps, Army of the Potomac. And of course, Major General John F. Reynolds, 1st Corps Army of the Potomac. I think I'm gonna compose courier message to... Actually, these are all the people I have in command of, so... This is pretty insane, though, that you can do this. I'm gonna get Caleb to report his status. What is your current... Send message. So then my courier is gonna head away from, not from Reynolds, but from Buford, who I am in. That's technically me. He should be riding through the forest here. He's heading to Caleb here, which is that's William Gamble. Caleb ought to be around here somewhere. There he is. He's in charge of the A battery here in the center, and of course on the left flank. Substantial stuff going on here. Now we gotta turn and face that enemy. We'll hold them there for now. Looks like the Confederate attack is coming to an halt here. But we need to be relieved still. Whoa, they broke? Shit. That I did not see. 12th Illinois broke as well, weakened and in the center. More Confederate regiments are regathering here and forming up. That's never good. But we'll deal with them later. Let's try and save our skin for now. James Archer. Archer's brigade. 12th Illinois cavalry here. High ground bonus and everything. They're doing pretty good, I gotta say. 8th New York and the 8th Illinois here working together. The 8th and 8th. Gunning it out pretty well there. These guys are going for a pretty aggressive approach. Oh, they're out of ammo. That's why. Out of ammo. 7 shots remaining per 12. We gotta get that ammo supply train going here again. Ordnance supply. Well, you better get going that way. We're out of ammo, no doubt. Because they're starting to run out of ammo. Pulling back here slightly. 10 minutes past 10 now, or 12 actually. 8th New York holding down on the side. Haven't got much ammo left though. And they are wavering. They're gonna fall back. Laying it down pretty good on this there. Artillery's of course providing support. What a mess. Center is free there for the Alabama boys. Think I might... I haven't got any... They're not that type of cavalry that I'm thinking of when I think of cavalry. Obviously. You guys are pretty much just mounted. 8th Illinois pulling back. And there goes the 8th New York, panicked and pulled back. Well, pretty much goes our entire defense. I think the Confederates can pretty much march into us right now. Unless Buford and his men finally do arrive. We could set up a defense further back, though. They're right here. It's like they're not time to come in yet, though. Following a certain time. I'm not sure when he did arrive in. Did the courier get the status yet? We'll set up a second line right here. We'll rearm, refuel. Not refuel, but you catch my drift. Men of Illinois, is this what you do? So I'm marching up on the side here. Center is pretty much clean though, they haven't done anything there. Joseph R. Davis and the 42nd Mississippi still on the flank. Not sure what the other, how they're gonna act with this. We're still giving down, we're laying down lots of artillery fire there on the 13th Alabama. We need to defend McPherson's Ridge here. We're not really defending McPherson's Ridge by being up there. Mortars. Well, you catch your drift. Just head there. Get the ordnance, boys. 13, they ought to be getting more and more every second now. They're resting, regathering our strength here. Here's the 8th Illinois. There we go. I don't know who's in charge of them. There's the 3rd Indiana. think it is... Someone's... Some AI has taken auto control. Per se, no? They're fully charged. These guys could get some more ammo. We're heading back to the defense there. We gotta defend it. There's no other way. Why don't you mount up? Why don't you ride there? Full haste. Why don't you mount up? Why don't you ride there as well? Why don't you head there as well? Why don't you head there as well? There's Reynolds and his boys, but they're just not showing up just yet. They're not triggered to arrive just yet. There's Buford. How you doing, Buford? Still gotta defend McPherson's Ridge, push these Confederates back. So there will always be some unhistorical turn of events. I mean, what'd you expect? Gonna place that gun there. We need to defend up here now. So Caleb, set your guns out for that. We'll split the guns on either side of the trench. One will provide cover for the 3rd Indiana, preparing to move up again. Supply train could only get here quicker. Artillery is opening up again. In line, on foot. We will advance. Not yet. Soon, though. We'll set them all up. These guys need ammo, too. These guys are fine. It's the massive 8th New York. Oh! Reynolds is finally arriving. The 8th is broken though, they're not gonna head back in. Not close enough. Let's get these guys resupplied. Let's push these sons of bitches back. Once and for all, boys. Artillery is doing a pretty good job of picking them off. They're laying down. I don't know why archers. Is this archer? Yeah. Okay, we're ready for a bit of a firefight, boys. Well, let's go then. Let's go. Oh shit, they were hiding. Indiana, refueled and ready to go, or refilled. Artillery is just opening up now. There's plenty of Confederates coming in again here. The 42nd, 2nd, 55th North Carolina, R. Davis, and Henry Heath. Oh, it's Henry Heath, Major General Henry Heath. Oh yeah, Heath's division. Oh, of course. The movie makes sense, I guess, or the battle, or the names come to play again. As they have been. Now we just need to set up here. Defend against the oncoming from that direction. These guys are almost out of ammo. Trust me, I dislike this much as everyone else. Fire will, guys. Fire away. 8th New York. I'm gonna send them in. Who do they think they are? Can just sit back. It's Wadsworth's coming in here. 1st Division, 1st Corps. The Senator Cutler on his way to the right here with two regiments. The 76th New York and the 56th Pennsylvania. Both of the 2nd Brigade here. Got the 1st Division, 1st Corps. 2nd Brigade as well, 147th New York, heading to the center, I believe, to reinforce. We have the 14th Brooklyn, the 84th New York, the 95th New York, and the 56th Pennsylvania. Did I mention them? I probably did. And then we have a whole bunch of other guys coming in. We've got the Iron Brigade coming in back here. The 6th Wisconsin, 7th Wisconsin, 19th Indiana, the 28th. Should be here as well. 24th Michigan, that's what I meant. James Hall and his artillery. He will not play his part yet. Is this the over the field they marched into the forest to fight the Confederates? 84th New York on their way in here. I mean, I feel bad for this gun. Can't feel that confident. Although they do. Let's make some way for the infantry. Let's not slack about. We've all got ammo, though. Plenty. 8th Illinois, though, is starting to fall behind a bit on the ammo. I'm not gonna blow the retreat. Really lots of back and forward here. And 8th New York coming in again. Day 2, low on ammo. But sometimes we can handle it right, I guess. Good to see some proper Union infantry arriving. Forward! Union blue! The last of the 13th Alabama here in Tennessee. Soldiers with Archer. And hold them back. Sir, you are right on the front line. Get back, sir. 2nd Mississippi laying down here in the ditch. Trying to avoid artillery, I guess. This is a massive ditch. Cross into it and over. Finally, here come the Brooklyn boys. New York boys, should I say. Well, technically, 14th Brooklyn, you know, still. Suaves. They weren't really Suaves, but still. They're pictured as Suaves in this game. Although, I think they should have a unique skin. They don't. That's fine. If Illinois... temporarily pull them back. That's not how it works. You can't leave the 30 Indiana out there. William Gamble. You and your brigade will need to hold. Got 1,069 men remaining. Probably made up of all the different cavalry regiments nearby. 427 casualties this far. We're about almost an hour in to the battle soon. Slightly pull them back here. Here come the New York boys. Brush Fowler in command. Colonel Edward Brush Fowler. Or Fowler, should I say. Not Fowler. I don't know what that would be. 84th New York. Those are their peer units. Major General. Reynolds, yes. Reynolds, otherwise. guys remain in cover here. We need to flush them out too, boys. We need to flush them out. Not sure what these guns are targeting. Target is blocked. There we go. Now we're talking. They're also firing at the 42nd Mrs. or the 42nd. Let's lay down some fire, boys. Right there in front of us. 2nd Mississippi. Oh. 40 Brooklyn marching through the cornfield soon, huh? Yeah, that's something like it, huh? There we go. I think everything is starting to play out as it should. Have I mentioned that they're making a Napoleonic version of this of Waterloo? Like all the surrounding battles and the entire battle itself, with just a bunch of fucking Brits, Prussians, and French. Like all the regiments remade and skinned accurately, like the Highlanders, the 92nd, 42nd, 79th, you name it. Can't wait for that. I'm almost looking pretty good on these guys in the center. As long as we can keep the center strong, we're doing the right things. We'll allow the infantry to position themselves and then we'll push them forward. That is the plan here. 8th New York and 8th Illinois. These guys both need rearmamenting or refueling. Oh, why do I say refueling? Resupplying. There we go. That's what I meant. That isn't hard, Simon. His ordnance is on his way back here to the to Wadsworth. You can do better than that. Got plenty of Union boys coming in here looking for that ammo. Oh. Looks like we're pushing them out. Still got some boys to deal with there in the cornfield. Behind the cornfield, should I say. But we'll move them. We'll move up and we'll mop them out. Mop them out. Sometimes I lose the ability to speak. Third gun. Not really looking to aim at a lot of things. We'll move it up. Have we lost one of the guns here on this flank? Feels like it. And Brooklyn men are laying dead there on the ground. What are they waiting for? Is staying down gonna help you now? No. Not. What a hit. I think we killed someone. And then we're doing something right, aren't we? Oh, they're starting to get up now. Oh! We won. Okay, right. A battle in Pennsylvania was fought in the vicinity of Gettysburg today. Reports are arriving by telegram to this office as the fight continues, but victory or defeat is still unknown. I mean, I guess. Wish good fortune to the troops on that faraway field, and as always, when prepared to the wars, casualty list are to follow. Score 1057. I don't know if there was a goal. Battle Gettysburg from Drive, blah, blah, blah. Right. Battle details. Oof. 1056. Our casualty is 488, and the enemy casualty is 1080, so that's good. Yeah? Top commanders here. Hidden. That was good though. I'm gonna close for now. I'm gonna exit the battle. And we're gonna look at 1057, right? So the score for that was, oh, that's a draw. Well, fine, because we pushed them back, but it's not like the Battle of Gettysburg is decided, you know. I'll be fine with that, as long as we killed more and we pushed them back. By me, that's fine. Right now, we're gonna go to what continues after this. We're gonna place Heath's division. And the Federal Militia is certainly stubborn. They don't seem to understand what they're up against. Now your full division is nearly up in line and the situation will change. Take McPherson's Ridge. So even if we get 1,000, we do a minor defeat. So I guess, you know, this is going to be interesting. I think it's going to be hard. But this is technically, this is 10:30 a.m. That's kind of like when this battle ended. So now we might be pushing back again. Who knows? Who knows? Who knows? Here's another one at the same time. This is the Iron Brigade, of course. And Cutler's Brigade is engaged to your front. Looks like the fight is coming your way. Hold McPherson's Ridge. That's the third scenario, and that is the fourth right there. Your division just crested Oak Hill, a wooded elevation overlooking the small town of Gettysburg. Before you in the distance appear to be the flank of the Federals, a hard struck blow here would bring the fight to a close. So it's all about McPherson's Ridge here, and then we move around, so to speak. But yeah, holy crap, interesting. I liked it, I hope you guys liked it. I'll see you guys soon again, and we're gonna head to McPherson's Ridge. Until then, you guys enjoy. Bye.